Hey guys, I'm Dhanya and this is Gindi Times, the official magazine of CEG, ACT and SAP. Today I would like to introduce you all to the ever smiling Vidya Lakshmi ma'am, who is an associate professor in the Department of Physics. Apart from being a source of knowledge and inspiration to everyone in the classroom, she is also known by her peers as a very humble and grounded person. It is a pleasure to have you here today, ma'am, with us.
Come to this Gindi Times. Hi to all students.
Thank you, ma'am. So, starting the interview, my first question to you is, ma'am, you have secured your PhD from the University of Durban, Westville. So, what inspired you to take physics as a career?
What made me to take physics as a career? Initially, I was not like so much interested, but I felt that I can do so much thing with physics. So that's the reason I took BSc as my physics, and then I wanted to continue further my education, MSc also, and I had the opportunity to go to South Africa. So there when I went, my father was working there. So when I went there, I asked my father I wanted to do my higher studies, and he was like a person who always encourages us to do higher studies. So he made me to go and see the physics department, how it is, and I went there and inquired, and they said, yeah, you can come and join for a PhD. So then I joined. I did my doctorate actually in plasma physics, which is a very theoretical physicist. I'm basically a theoretical physicist. Now I have become an experimentalist. And after that, actually, I was very fortunate to complete my PhD within 3 years. Then after coming over here, I had the opportunity to join Anna University. So, and I really now enjoy more physics than while I was studying, actually.
That's really nice to hear, ma'am. Now, coming to your teaching style, usually students find physics very tough or very dry. So what strategies do you use to make it more engaging and make it more understandable? And could you share an example?
Definitely. Actually, generally, that this thing is there for among all the students. Starting from the school days, I think physics has been a very tough subject for them to understand. There's a lot of concepts involved in that. But if we practically start to understand the concept through the live examples which we see in our day, it makes it more interesting for us. Normally, I am more into sports. Like, I'm not actually doing any sports, but I enjoy watching the sports. When I watch the sports, I always see a lot of physics phenomena involved in that. For example, when I was teaching the cantilever experiment, like, you know, cantilever topic, I always tell the students, like, you can see the swimming pool, you know, when you go to there, and when you wanted to dive into the pool and you come to the edge of that, okay. And then that is how the cantilever is. You come to the edge of that, and then you started jumping from there. And all the lot of in swimming also, from the time you start to jump from the diving board until you reach inside the water, and after that also while swimming, whether you use any kind of stroke, every step is full of physics concepts which are involved in that. Starting from the cantilever, where the energy, the potential energy, which gets converted into kinetic energy, and as you jump, it's a conservation of angular momentum which makes you to fold your body, and then while landing into the water, you wanted to extend your hands and legs so that your impact on the water will be less. So there also, and after that, you will be using different kinds of stroke inside the water. That also a lot of physics which is involved. So if you are able to connect with the live examples which we see every day, so nowadays I think IPL is going on, so many students, they like to watch cricket, and cricket is also one of the wonderful game where you find a lot of physics. I don't know whether the person who is playing know physics or not. If they know physics, I think they can still more much better play the game, I feel. So if you, I don't know how many of you all know about this, those who know cricket, I think they know that there is a place called in a bat, sweet spot that is called. So that is a spot where you find that the ball, whether the ball is hitting the bat or not, also you will not feel. That spot is the, actually known as the fundamental node of vibration. That is what is, it will actually be there from the handle to the tip of the bat. You can find anywhere it will be there. Any other places the ball falls means you will feel the vibration till the handle. But this one place alone, you will not feel any vibration at all. That's called sweet spot. So like that, from the bowler's point of view, you see that spinning also, a lot of physics involved, aerodynamics is there. So it is very interesting to understand physics through the examples of which you come across. For me, it is sports which I see. So whenever I watch a sport, I always see what is the physics behind that. So that makes me to enjoy more the sport also. That's how I
That's actually very interesting, ma'am. Now, as you know, each campus has its own character and charm. So, having worked in this CG campus, what do you think makes it unique compared to other environmental situations, environmental education?
From my past 20 years of experience in this university, I would say I have been very, very fortunate to be in this university, because I see students from various backgrounds, okay, not only from top or bottom, various backgrounds. And I was always when I see the students, even from coming from rural area also, they have a tremendous knowledge also. Only thing is, language was the barrier for them to express it. I have seen many, in my experience, many students who have a very good knowledge. So that helped me to understand the student also much better, and it gave a very wonderful experience. And now I am very proud that I am in this university. The reason, because it stands among the all the state and central university, among the top 10 universities in India there. So it is a really a proud thing. I think top one university, which is top one institute, which is very close by us, but we are also there among the state universities. So very proud, and that too it is in Hindi. So we should be very proud of this university. I am really very proud, because students have given me very wonderful experiences. I have also learned from them also many things. That's a wide range of students you get here.
So, I mean, I think as students of the university, even we can vouch for the fact. Now, finally, on a light note, if you could travel back in time and meet any famous physicist, who would it be and why?
If you take it at the global level, definitely Einstein would be my favorite physicist whom I would like to meet. The reason, because he has contributed tremendous in the field of physics. Okay, starting from you can talk about special theory of relativity and general theory of relativity, Brownian motion, and even in fact he has also contributed for the quantum mechanics, and also he has also contributed for the if you see that Einstein photoelectric effect. After the Planck's quantum theory, he actually got Nobel Prize for his photoelectric effect, and also he made what is the most admiring thing about him is he predicted, he was basically a theoretical physicist. He predicted many things. All his theories are one by one are becoming experimentally, with the technology advancement we are able to do. Even today, laser is also one of the things. Actually, he predicted long time before if we are able to get a very high coherent beam of light. There are many things which we can do with that. I think that has come true today. You can see that. So, and coming from the point of Indian, as an Indian, I feel Jagadish Chandra Bose, who is one of the unsung genius of this, of India. Okay, so actually he could have been given a Nobel Prize. He couldn't get it. Marconi got a Nobel Prize for radio waves, but his detector watch, what he actually found out, was used by Marconi also. So, and he has also contributed for the wireless communication which we are talking about today. He is a father of wireless communication, where he has found also microwaves, using microwaves, how we can detect. And he has developed one detector which is called Coherer. And so a lot of contribution he has made, and he has also studied crescograph, it's called, to study the how plant behaves with the external stimuli also, he has done that. So we can maybe call him as a biophysicist also. So he has done a lot of contributions. So I admire him a lot. So if I get a chance, I can meet both of them.
Thank you so much, ma'am. With this, I would like to conclude the interview. It has truly been very insightful, and I would like to thank you to take time out of your busy schedule and join us here today. So thank you once again.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.